Alright, this is going to be a closer look at the inside of the Soundesign CD player from 1986. The one thing I noticed right away that's kind of a sign of the cheapness of the Soundesign brand is that the back and bottom of the case are made of fiberboard, which is basically a stiffer form of cardboard, basically. They do put tin foil shielding on the bottom part, because usually that part would be made of metal. So that's, you don't usually see tin foil inside a CD player. So I guess that's the one giveaway that this is a cheap brand from the 80s. Otherwise, the components seem pretty standard for CD players at the time. Except for one thing I noticed is that the eject button has mostly a mechanical design to it. There's actually a metal piece here. See, I just actually pushed it with my finger there. When you push the button, it not only just engages a switch here on the front panel, it actually moves a mechanism back and forth that's spring-loaded, and there's a micro switch here that tells it when the door is all the way open. So that's kind of a unique design. I haven't seen it before in a tray loading CD player. And I got a question in the comments to my previous video if this would play CDRs. Now my 1987 Realistic does not play CDRs. It either gives you very glitchy audio or it just reads the track information and does not play them at all. This one does play CDRs. This CDR I have in my hand right here was actually burned and then thrown out by my college roommate way back when. And I rescued it because I had some kind of nice songs on it. And I don't know if you can see, it's kind of scuffed up. I mean, it's not really scratched, but it's obviously not a brand new burn. But it seems to play fine, or at least as fine as any other CD player can play it. Because a couple of the songs were from really crappy MP3 files, so they don't sound that great. But it does play, plays fine, tracks fine. And I'll give you the audio of this little gear motor loading the CD. Alright, I'll hit play here.
Baby, let's cruise.
No way from here.
Don't be confused.
No way.
Alright. I don't know if any of these songs are banned from YouTube due to copyright reasons, so I don't want to play the whole song here. I think that glitch was on the CD. The glitch was from the MP3. I know what that sound is. It's the sound of a glitchy MP3 file. So that's what you're hearing. It's not a fault of the CD player, and it's not a fault of the CD itself. It's from the MP3 file that the CD was burned from. Let's try to find that again. Yep, I think a lot of people would know that sound from downloading MP3s and finding them to be full of glitches like that. So.
Lifetime, maybe too much to ask, but I swear from now on, if ever you're in my arms again, this time I'll love you much better. This time I'll hold you. this time will never end.
That's a really nice song. It's 1984, I think, maybe 85. There you can hear the stereo separation.
You sheltered me from harm, kept me warm, kept me warm. You gave my life to me, set me free, set me free.
All right. It's a newer song here. It's a really crappy MP3 files out that was from. You can hear all the grungy artifacts.
Don't wanna go home right now.
This is a song that's on Hotel California, which should be out in a couple weeks. This song features Don Henley on lead vocal. This is called Wasted Time.
It's a live version. Alright. Well, you get the gist of it. So it does play CD-R discs. About as fine as any other CD player can play them. So that's good compared to my realistic. I was going to feature another song from Westlife, but maybe another video another time. I think that's about it for now for the sound design. All right, thanks for watching.
I won.